Getting puffed up or arrogant or prideful about yourself is the greatest danger and the way Satan wedges into your life to try to get you to turn away from God and actually begin to look at yourself as, boy, look at me. You know, you start getting prideful and arrogant. If you know people who live in that pride and that arrogance, it's offensive. You get sick and tired of being around people like that. If you want to have a lot of friends, go to one another with humility. It's very endearing to be humble. And love doesn't behave rudely. If you know people that act that way, it's the word literally means shamefully. It doesn't just mean rude, it's a shame. People should not shame themselves acting that way. And love doesn't seek its own. Love never looks for its own advantage, but it's always thinking about how can I benefit someone else. You ever know somebody like that? They're always thinking about others, how they can give them a ride, or how they can mentor them, or how they can love them, how they can help them, whatever. That's a sign the Holy Spirit's working in you. And it doesn't just seek itself. And love isn't provoked. The couple that I saw there this morning were so easily provoked with one another, and I thought, what they both need to do is zip it. Just zip it. And listen to one another. If one of them's mad, there must be a reason they're mad. If they got a personal problem, come back, could be for years before that. It helps you to avoid becoming angry when you don't allow yourself to get provoked just by something someone else did because they're having a bad day. And love doesn't think evil. Love doesn't keep a record of wrongs. You know, some people say, you always... That'll get trouble going. Or you never, always and never, leave those out. Leave them out. Don't do the always and never and pull out your book. Oh, I've been keeping track of you. Henry, that's 498 rocky roads you need this week. Don't be mad, I can see the chocolate on your face. I'm glad for Henry if he can have the rocky road.
Yeah,
amen. He says amen. It's like some people, they just get so wound up with this. They think evil things toward one another. Don't do it. And love doesn't rejoice in iniquity. Some people really like to see others get hurt. You've ever seen that? They're kind of like happy when somebody else's car breaks down. they're kind of happy when somebody else loses a job. They're happy when they got sick and I didn't. That's wrong. It's just like nuts. People shouldn't be thinking that kind of thing. If you're a child of God, rejoice in the truth. Rejoice in justice. Rejoice in what is the best for other people. And rejoice in the truth. Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the life, and the truth. If you rejoice in the truth, you're rejoicing in Christ himself. Loving God and others will cause you to develop a virtue, a godly character, and become more mature until you become more like Jesus Christ. That's what happens. And it bears all things. Love bears up when the going's hard. When things are hard and you see somebody else struggling, you know what love also does? Love says, let me help you. I want to help you share the shoulder of the load. Jesus Christ said that. If you want to become like him, Matthew chapter 11, verse 29, he said, take my yoke upon you and learn from me. I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you'll find rest for your souls. He said, my yoke is easy and my burden is light, because he has the power and the strength and the knowledge, the wisdom to know how to help. Put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ and learn from him. That's what he said. Learn from me, because my yoke is easy and my burden is light, because he helps you lift the load. That's what we're supposed to do for one another. The way we're treating our Lord Jesus Christ. You are the temple of God's Spirit, each of you. How we act toward one another, love one another, help one another, listen to one another, whatever. We're doing it for Christ. Don't ever forget that. Very important.